There used to be a theory that real London humour wouldn't go north of Watford. That's been disproven. Kids love you. Grown-ups love you. Yes, all classes seem to love you.
I get worried about some of the children.
Why?
Well, they write to me and say, you're just like my father, or you're just like my uncle. And I think that's terrible if there are fathers and uncles like Arthur Daly.
I think we all have a brother-in-law or an uncle who is Arthur, or could have been Arthur, or who would like to be Arthur.
I can't imagine anyone wanting to be Arthur. Because, I mean, when you look at the end of each day, he's always lost. He always loses. And the money he's lost is terrible, sad.
I'm going to use the word once more, seedy, just to see what your reaction is this time.
He is not seedy. He's almost elegant. He's got nice clothes, got nice manner.
Can I jump back? The first film clip we saw, Cottage to Let, how old were you then? You made that film?
Just 15.
And how did you get started? You come from South London, like Arthur himself.
Yes. Dennis and I come from the Golden Triangle. I come from Tooting, he comes from Clapham.
And you reckon Arthur would be what? Bermondsey or Bellamy or what?
I would have thought Arthur would be East End.
He's not a Southern boy.
No, I wouldn't have thought so.
No, you said you could have become an Arthur in real life. Is that because of your own childhood background?
Well, I think when I was a child actor, I had a terrible Cockney accent. And it was pointed out to me by Alastair Sim and his wife that if you didn't do something about it, you'd be playing Cockney parts for the rest of your life. Well, if I hadn't done something about it, I might have stayed a Cockney character and I could see something like Arthur.
Before you became a child actor, without a Cockney accent, what were you? Where were you? Who were your parents? What kind of schooling had you had?
I went to a council school in Morden. I left when I was 14. I left on the Friday. I got a job on the Saturday. And that was it. I was on tour. I got a job by answering an advertisement in the newspaper.
And what did the advertisement say?
Young boy wanted for a West End musical. That was the other musical I did. That was in 1939, White Horse Inn.
And had you had any experience?
No, not at all.
What put this idea in your head? Because you don't just casually look at help wanted ads for
young
boys.
No, but I think I'd been in school plays and things like that, and school concerts, and got into trouble with the headmaster for singing things like When I'm Cleaning Windows. I performed a bit. I'm not sure I wanted to be an actor. I think I probably wanted to be a comic singer. And I used to sell newspapers around the streets, and then on the Friday night after I'd left school, I went and sort of read through the three London papers then, and it was the Star that had the advertisement in, and it gave an address in Gerrard Street off Shaftesbury Avenue. So I went off on the Saturday morning to Gerrard Street, auditioned. In fact, I can remember I was asked what I could do, and I said, well, I can do a poem by Julius Caesar called Friends, Romans, Countrymen. And so I did that. I didn't get the part, but I got the understudy, and I was in about 12 choruses, drummer boy, farm boy, all the way through. And I took off that afternoon on tour, sent my parents a telegram saying I'd gone on the stage and I'd let them know where I was staying. And I came back about 6 months later.
At the age of 14?
Mm.
Had your parents any idea of this ambition of yours?
Or? I don't know. I always thought, well, how marvellous they were letting me do that, you know, as a young man. I've always thought, what marvellous parents I had letting me do that. But as I've got older, I've thought, they were a rotten lot. I mean, why didn't they come after me or get onto the police or something? But no, they didn't.
Were you happy to leave school, or did you feel...
Yes,
why?
I didn't like school.
Because I have a feeling that you're when I say bookish... That almost sounds nasty, doesn't it? I feel that you're a bookish person.
Yes, I'm bookish. Yes. I've got a lot of books. Read books.
So what was the matter with the kind of education you got?
It was marvellous. It was a lovely education. And I did very well at school. There were three of us. We were always first, second, third in the class, right the way through from 11 to 14. It was a good secondary school education. But if I'd done what the headmaster had lined up for me, I'd have been a messenger boy in a butcher's shop in Morden. but I had the luck to see the advertisement, get the job, took the job, came to London with White Horse Inn, played at the Coliseum. The boy I was understudying went for an audition for a play. His mother said, would I like to go and keep him company because there'd be some famous actors there, and I said yes. And by some accident or other, I was auditioned as well, and I got the part.
And from then on, has it been one amiable path of success, or is it...?
It's had its bad patches. I think the worst I've had was 11 months out of work. But I was sufficiently arrogant not to think I ought to get another job.
In 40 years, only 11 months resting?
Well, no, I've had months, 3 months, 4 months, 2 months, but 11 months was the worst.
So once you were appearing, was it the Coliseum, you said?
Yes.
Did you go back to Tooting? Did they consider you there, your old neighbours, your old friends, a glamorous person or weird?
No, not then. I think after Cottage to Let they did, because
the, film, yes.
the play, because that ran for about 9 months at Wyndham's, and then the Blitz came and all the theatres closed down. Then we opened up again, went out on tour, it came into Wyndham's again and played another 9 months. And it was a very big part for a little boy. It was a Cockney evacuee who worshipped Sherlock Holmes. I think then they thought it was a bit glamorous.
Can I jump back? The first film clip we saw, Cottage to Let, how old were you then when you made that film?
Just 15.
And how did you get started? You come from South London, like Arthur himself.
Yes. Dennis and I come from the Golden Triangle. I come from Tooting, he comes from Clapham.
And you reckon Arthur would be what, Bermondsey or Belham?
I would have thought Arthur would be East End.
He's not a Southern boy.
I wouldn't have thought so.
Yeah. No, you said you could have become an Arthur in real life. Is that because of your own childhood background?
Well, I think if... when I was a child actor, I had a terrible Cockney accent. And it was pointed out to me by Alistair Sim and his wife that if you didn't do something about it, you'd be playing Cockney parts for the rest of your life. Well, if I hadn't done something about it, I might have stayed a Cockney character and I could see something like Arthur.
Before you became a child actor, or without a Cockney accent, what were you?
In Gerrard Street, off Shaftesbury Avenue. So I went off on the Saturday morning to Gerrard Street, auditioned. In fact, I can remember I was asked what I could do. And I said, well, I can do a poem by Julius Caesar called Friends, Romans, Countrymen. And so I did that. I didn't get the part, but I got the understudy. And I was in about 12 choruses, drummer boy, farm boy, all the way through. And I took off that afternoon on tour, sent my parents a telegram saying I'd gone on the stage and I let them know where I was staying. And I came back about 6 months later.
At the age of 14?
Mm.
Had your parents any idea of this ambition of yours?
I don't know. I always thought, well, how marvellous they were letting me do that, you know, as a young man. I've always thought, what marvellous parents I had letting me do that. But as I've got older, I've thought, they're a rotten lot. I mean, why don't they come after me or get onto the police or something? But no, they didn't.
There used to be a theory that real London humour wouldn't go north of Watford. That's been disproven. Kids love you. Grown-ups love you. Yes? All classes seem to love you.
I get worried about some of the children.
Why?
They write to me and say, you're just like my father, or you're just like my uncle. And I think that's terrible if there are fathers and uncles like Arthur Daly.
I think we all have a brother-in-law or an uncle who is Arthur, or could have been Arthur, or who would like to be Arthur.
I can't imagine anyone wanting to be Arthur. Because, I mean, when you look at the end of each day, he's always lost. He always loses. And the money he's lost is terrible, sad.
I'm going to use the word once more, seedy, just to see what your reaction is
he
this time.
He is not seedy. He's almost elegant. He's got nice clothes, got nice manner.
Were you happy to leave school, or did you feel...
Yes,
why?
I didn't like school.
Because I have a feeling that you're a... When I say bookish, that almost sounds nasty, doesn't it? I feel that you're a bookish person.
Yes, I'm bookish. Yes, I've got a lot of books. read books.
So what was the matter with the kind of education you got?
Nothing, it was marvellous. It was a lovely education. And I did very well at school. There were three of us. We were always first, second, third in the class, right the way through from 11 to 14. No, it was a good secondary school education. But if I'd done what the headmaster had lined up for me, I'd have been a messenger boy in a butcher's shop in Morden. But I had the luck to see the advertisement, get the job, took the job, came to London with White Horse Inn, played at the Coliseum. The boy I was understudying went for an audition for a play. His mother said, would I like to go and keep him company? Because
where were you? Who were your parents? What kind of schooling had you
had? I went to a council school in Morden. I left when I was 14. I left on the Friday. I got a job on the Saturday. And that was it. I was on tour. I got a job balancing an advertisement newspaper.
And what did the advertisement say?
Young boy wanted for a West End musical. That was the other musical I did. That was in 1939. White Horse Inn.
And had you had any experience?
No, not at all.
What put this idea in your head? Because you don't just casually look at help wanted ads for
no,
young
but
boy.
I think I'd been in school plays and things like that, and school concerts, and got into trouble with the headmaster for singing things like When I'm Cleaning Windows. And, I mean, I you know, performed a bit. I wanted to be, I'm not sure I wanted to be an actor. I think I probably wanted to be a comic singer. And I used to sell newspapers around the streets, and then on the Friday night after I'd left school, I went and sort of read through the three London papers then. And it was the Star that had the advertisement in, and it gave an address.